What if customers pay before you give the product or service that you're selling them? This video will teach you how to record that in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Customer deposits and prepayments basically mean the same thing. They are both a situation where you received payment from a customer before giving them the product or service. The service is owed to the customer until you deliver the service. We use the receive payments window to record situations where the customer pays in advance. QuickBooks Online cannot print a deposit receipt the way QuickBooks Desktop can if you follow the steps in the equivalent desktop video. However, you could still print your own deposit or prepayment receipt from Excel or any other source and simply record the transaction into QuickBooks Online. So what happens when the customer pays in advance? Well, cash or undeposited funds must increase because you just received money from a customer. And when you receive money from a customer, accounts receivable and the customer records go down. This means if it's a new customer, and this is their first transaction, they will actually have a negative balance, and that indicates that you actually owe them until the service is rendered. The payment stays in the customer records as an unapplied credit until you actually do the job and earn the income. So that means at the moment we actually deliver the service, accounts receivable goes back up from the reduced amount that we recorded when we received the payment. And of course, because we delivered the service, the income account that we earned goes up as well at the moment we deliver the service. Now, the way we record this is that we make an invoice the way we normally would when we do a job. Then, after recording the invoice, we use the receive payment window to apply the new invoice we just made to the past credit at the moment we receive the money. For example, let's imagine on March 24th, Alan paid us $700 cash in advance of a future job that is completely unrelated to any currently open invoice. We will record this in the receive payments window. We will imagine that the money was directly deposited into the bank account. And we will not apply the payment to any open invoice because it is meant to be applied to a future job. Now here we are looking at the Allen section of the open invoice report before we record the payment. To do this, you open the new transaction menu. Either click on the top left where it says new, or if you don't have that, go to the top right and click the plus sign close to the cogwheel. Either one will open the same choices in the new transaction menu. And we go to the customer column and we go down and click receive payment. Now the date in our little story for this transaction is March 24th of 2017. And we know that the customer is Alan and that the money was deposited directly to the bank account and that the payment method in this case was cash. The amount we receive, and we type in $700. Now, be careful. QuickBooks will automatically put the check mark in the top one and apply it to the oldest invoice.
What you have to do is remove the check mark so that the $700 is not applied to any of the previous invoices, because we did not do work yet for this particular $700. As soon as we click Save and Close, the most important moment is this message. This message is telling us that we did not apply the credit or the payment to any particular invoice, and therefore we should save it as a credit. And in this case, we agree with QuickBooks Online and we click Save as Credit. Now, when we look at the open invoice report, we see that we have a payment that's only showing on the open invoice report because it has not yet been applied to any invoice. It will be applied to the invoice that we actually got paid for at the moment we make the invoice. Let's take a look.
And now, let's imagine on March 25th, we actually did the 5 editing hours that we got paid for the day before and applied the $700 payment from March 24th to this job. First, we have to click the plus sign, go over to Invoice, choose Alan, and of course put the date that we're doing in our little story, March 25th of 2017. In this case, the item is editing and the number of hours we did in this example is 5. That makes $700 for invoice number 22 for Alan on March 25th. Now, when we click Save and Close, which is probably the best thing to click, you can see that the invoice that we made is still open and the payment still has not been applied. So at the very same moment you make the invoice that you have already been paid for, you click the plus sign, you go to the Receive Payments window, and again you choose Alan. Make sure the date is the same day as the invoice that we did the job, and you have to obviously click both the invoice that we're getting paid for as well as the unapplied payment. Check them both and only those two, because the only reason that you're in this Receive Payment window at the moment you're making the invoice is to simply apply the previously received payment to the invoice we just made. That means the actual amount received on March 25th, on the day you did the job, is zero. So we click Save and Close, and when we go back to the open invoice, you can see both the payment and the invoice have disappeared. Now, before we finish, I would like to state clearly what's good about this method of recording prepaids and deposits from customers. What's good is that the customer records are always accurate at any given moment, and that it's easy to manage customer data and reconcile with customers regarding what is owed and what is used. However, what is slightly imperfect about this method is that the accounts in the chart of accounts will be temporarily inaccurate until the work is actually done. Advanced payments lowers accounts receivable instead of increasing an account called unearned income, which is a current liability. But don't worry. The ledger accounts can stay slightly inaccurate in this particular way until it's time to report your numbers. And then when you have to, if you have to report your numbers before you actually did the work, then you can make a normal accountant adjustment to temporarily fix your numbers until the work is done.